You're back.
Yes, yes.
And more importantly, you're alive.
You better believe it.
We got some stories. So last week, I was in Nashville. I called it Graceland because Grace was showering down all over Carolyn and I. And, you know, I ended up in the Grand Ole Opry stage. My cowboy boots will be coming soon. I will be wearing those.
Ooh, whoopee.
Parking spots opened. Weather, I mean, everything was falling into place. However, this is nothing, pales in comparison to the grace that was bestowed upon our queen here in the last couple of weeks, because there were some incidences, and we're going to talk about them today. So what happened to you in the last couple of weeks, Queenie?
I had some woman drive her car into me. I was in the passenger seat of our car. My husband was driving, and going into a restaurant, the lanes were stopped, and he proceeded, and all of a sudden, I turned, and there was a car coming right at me. Mm. Nothing I could do. I, of course, had my seatbelt on, which saved
me.
Very good. And the airbags exploded and wrapped me around. I know God did it. Yeah. I mean, it was a God thing, because those bags and that seatbelt protected me from what could have been a fatal accident.
Yes.
And it totaled our car immediately. The cars were locked together, so they put down a board, took out the back seat and trunk, and took me out that way. We went.
Time out. They took you out the trunk.
Yes.
They took her out the trunk. That's how bad the car was.
I was pretty woozy, but enough to know what was going on. They immediately hooked me up to some machines. We got to the hospital in a few minutes, you might say, and they began taking tests. And they looked at me, looked at my age, and thought, well, this one's not going to make it. They had me at some big body frame. And the doctor came in afterwards and shook his head and said, you're a miracle. I only had bruises on my chest and up here by my neck. And of course they hurt, but nothing was broken. And my heart was fine.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
No internal bleeding. Yeah. She's on blood thinners. Like, there's like a million things that could have gone wrong. That's just crazy.
And I think if people come in, in fact, and peek at me, knowing my age and the fact that I was sitting up in bed watching TV. I mean, they really were amazed. And I continue to thank God for that one.
Yeah.
We had a little trip planned.
Then she went on vacation.
Oh, yeah.
She was fine. She just had some bruised ribs up the next day and then went on a trip.
Yeah.
Why not?
I had some pain, but hey, no pain, no gain. And I'm not a pill pusher, that's for sure. But my husband loves trips. He'd never been to San Diego. I lived there for, 1989 to 2002. Taught at the high school. And then he decided he loved the Midwest, and we moved to Indiana, and it's been a joy ever since.
But you had a little mishap.
Well,
Mom, this is the thing that's very interesting about the queen here, is she had never been in the ocean until this trip, and so she had this gorgeous red new bathing suit.
Oh, yes.
Maybe an excuse to wear it. You just wanted to wear the suit.
Oh, yeah.
So she's like, okay, I'll go to the ocean.
Yeah.
So that's when mishap number two occurred.
King Edward used the GPS.
King Edward.
It landed us in downtown La Jolla, which I thought was strange, because all along the coast, the sandy beaches seemed to be, more out of town.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't have high walkways leading down
like
to
cliffs.
Them.
Like cliffs.
Yeah.
Should have been a clue.
It was
that
a cliff.
Should have been a clue,
where
maybe.
We parked.
This was not
we
the best
We parked
beach.
Up on a cliff, and I saw a lifeguard station. I saw people in wetsuits going down a stairway, and so I said, let's follow them. They've got to be going to the water.
Yeah, in the red bathing suit.
Oh, my. We must have gone 60 feet, maybe 70 feet down. a step at a time.
Very carefully.
And then my husband, I looked down there and that water was waist deep. And I thought, I've never been a swimmer. And so King Edward called on another man down there to help me step off into the water. He didn't have a chance. A wave came along bigger than a building maybe and swept me into the water. I had his hand and it saved my life. I'd have gone out with the current. Who knows where I'd have been floating now. But anyway, he grabbed my hand, my husband grabbed my hand, but I still had a couple more waves tossed me around and pushed me right into that sand that felt like concrete. And when I stepped out, I looked like a sandman. Anyway, the lifeguard took all the sand from upstairs.
I think you told me he was kind of cute, too.
Oh, he was. Yeah, I did notice that. And he carried me up the stairs.
Nice.
He was worried. He even fixed a cut on my foot, which I don't know where I got it. But anyway, he said to us, next time, and I thought, you're crazy. There's not going to be a next time. Next time, he said, don't come to this beach at noon. This is all high tides, and there's two currents that come together here and make it twice as bad. Hmm. That's why the expert swimmers want to come here, because they like to be carried out by those waves. But if they tried to carry me out, I wouldn't be sitting here today, and you wouldn't be wiggling around on my lap. But I'll tell you, God was with me.
Yes.
I mean, I was scared, but I don't let those things bother me. Ed picked up the soggy, wet, sandy towels. I got in on a garbage bag. He wouldn't let me sit on the seat. Took a couple of showers, kind of built a sand castle in the corner of the shower. That's how much sand.
That's a lot
my
of sand.
My eyes, my ears, my
you know survived. What. You survived. So any injuries? Yeah.
Not really.
None. No. Walked away from that one too.
I was
in the
worried.
Red suit.
Yeah, I was worried.
We're gonna post
about
a picture
suit.
Of that. Yeah.
But it's
the
fine.
Suit's fine.
And so
and you're
am
okay.
I.
Okay.
And believe me,
wow.
I have never been closer to my maker, I'll tell you. And I mean these things happen, but life goes on.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to let this get me down.
Yeah. So you're back home again in Indiana.
I am.
She's safe. We should mark her safe, like
safe.
You do on Facebook.
Oh,
not
yeah.
the hurricane. She wasn't in the hurricane. She was in her own hurricane situation, wave situation. So the queen is safe.
And I'm going to be home for a few weeks. Then we have a cruise. And that's about as close to the ocean as I'm going to get. Just to get on there.
We're going to have to line up some guests because you're not going to even be here on the porch.
No, I won't.
She's just taking off on the next trip.
I know.
Well, I brought you something that you clearly deserve after all these near-death experiences that I think you're going to like. And this is something that is very famous in Nashville.
Ooh.
The Goo Goos.
The Goo Goos.
Yes. These are Supreme Goo Goos. So I think it's time for a Goo Goo.
Well, not while I'm holding my grandson.
Here, I'll hold the dog.
Yes.
Okay, so
there
you
we
get
go.
A goo-goo.
A goo-goo. They sound good. So, I'll tell you that.
Sorry,
oh,
the
my.
Box. Yeah.
Oh, my.
The box might.
They're not all in here, so you know who might have
sampled
them.
Well, let me tell you.
Might have sampled them.
I live in a no-candy zone here. And so when candy is brought in, whether by myself or others, there's no guarantee
that it
will last. So you did get at least one, maybe two Goo Goos. Let's see the verdict on the Goo Goos. Good?
Very good. Very good.
How does it compare to what's in the tin?
Well,
maybe you need another bite.
Not right now. I'm going to get a drink. This is going to be hidden.
Goo-goos.
I'll have to...
Wait, where are you hiding it? She hid the goo-goos in her pants.
Well, I don't like them on display. You never know. And, you know, it's just a little
The goo-goos are hidden for now.
I might need
one
over here.
I'm not going...
No.
I'm not going in to get a cuckoo.
No.
Maybe one left in the box.
You can have this one.
Okay.
All right.
Well, so that's our crazy porch cast for the week. Wow. We're alive. We're good. We're goo-goo good. We got some goo-goos hidden. And we're going to keep talking about grace. In fact, I did a little Bible bits. I'm doing my little Bible thing now.
Good.
And I'm going to include that for those of you who are curious about the Bible, because the Bible is a book of God's grace. Like, the fact that we even have it is a huge sign of God's grace. So, so we're having a good week back home again in Indiana.
Well,
so
I'm melting.
Tune in.
I'm waiting for the change in weather.
Oh,
yes. I mean, it is so warm here. And it was warm out in San Diego area, too.
Yeah.
But, I like to say I'm a hot mama, and I get so warm sometimes I just want to tear it off.
Explode. Yeah, tear it. Don't be... We're not going to get naked on the porch.
No,
everybody just hold on.
Only in the castle.
Because then your goo-goo would come out. And
it's safe, right?
And secure. Okay. So thank you, Queenie. Thank you, God. We're good.
Oh, yeah.
We're signing off with the goo-goos. Yeah.